The SawStop safety system works by sending a small electrical signal through the blade. If a conductive material touches the blade, the system detects the reduction in signal and activates the brake. But what do you do if you need to cut a conductive material, such as carbon fiber, very wet wood, metals, a material that will activate the safety system? Further, what if you are unsure if the material is conductive? Use bypass mode. As the term suggests, bypass mode disables the safety system from activating the brake if the blade comes in contact with any conductive material. You can also use bypass mode to determine if a material is conductive. All SawStop saws are equipped with bypass mode. The method you use to initiate bypass mode is the same for all SawStop models, with the exception of the job site saw. Keep in mind that the safety system will not activate in bypass mode. In the first section of this video, you learn how to initiate bypass mode for all saws except the job site saw. The next section shows you how to initiate bypass mode for the job site saw. Finally, you learn how to test material conductivity. The brake cartridge must be installed correctly and all error codes must be cleared. See the owner's manual for further information. For all saws except the job site saw, use the following procedure. Push the start-stop pedal to make sure it's in the off position. Turn on the main power switch. Wait for the safety system to initialize. Wait for the red LED to stop flashing and turn off, and wait for a solid green LED. A solid green LED indicates the system is ready. Turn the bypass key clockwise and hold in this position. The red LED will flash once. When you've held the key for at least 2 seconds, the green LED should begin to blink slowly and continue to blink slowly. While still holding the key, pull the start-stop paddle to the on position within 10 seconds. The blade will start to spin and the red LED will flash once. Hold the key for 2 more seconds and then release the key. The green LED will be flashing slowly, indicating the saw is in bypass mode. When finished cutting, push the paddle to the off position. The system is in bypass mode until the blade comes to a complete stop. The safety system is still disabled until the blade stops. When the blade stops, the system exits bypass mode automatically, and the safety system goes into standby mode. The safety system will be active the next time you start the saw normally. That is, you do not start in bypass mode. Next, let's see how to initiate bypass mode for the job site saw. The procedure is very similar, with slightly different controls. Make sure the start-stop paddle is in the off position. Turn on the main power switch. Wait for the red LED to stop flashing and turn off, and wait for a solid green LED. Press and hold the bypass switch. The red LED will flash once. Continue to hold the bypass switch. Pull the start-stop paddle to the on position. Continue to hold the bypass switch until the red LED again flashes once. Release the bypass switch. The green LED flashes slowly, indicating the saw is in bypass mode. When finished cutting, push the paddle to the off position. The system is in bypass mode until the blade comes to a complete stop. The safety system is still disabled until the blade stops. Like the other SawStop models, when the blade stops, the system exits bypass mode automatically, and the safety system goes into standby mode. The safety system will be active the next time you start the saw normally. That is, you do not start in bypass mode. Finally, let's see how to test a material for conductivity. Run the saw in bypass mode. Carefully, make a test cut in the material. If the contact detected during bypass code displays, the red LED flashes rapidly. The material is conductive and you must cut in bypass mode. The red LED continues to flash until you press the paddle to turn off the saw and the blade comes to a complete stop. Again, keep in mind that the safety system is still disabled and the brake will not activate in bypass mode. See the owner's manual for further information. If you need a bypass key, you can purchase at our store on SawStop.com. If you have questions, contact SawStop Service.